Assalamu alaikum everyone, welcome back to another ATP video. Today we'll be talking about Legionella pneumophila. Although it will be a short, concise video, we will cover the most important details related to Legionella. Let us break down the name first. It's called Legionella because it was first identified at American Legion Convention, where there was an outbreak of pneumonia amongst the attendees of the conference. You can easily remember from the name that this bug causes pneumonia. Legionella is an aerobic facultative intracellular bacilli. Facultative intracellular, if you remember, it means it can grow inside and outside the host cells. Legionella pneumophila is also oxidase and catalase positive, non-encapsulated, so it doesn't have a capsule, and has a monopolar flagellum. Since it's an intracellular organism, it poorly stains with Gram stain. However, it's still considered a gram-negative rod. Now in the lab, it does not gram stain well, which is why we use silver stain to visualize it. It has special culture requirements as well. It's grown on a special agar called buffered charcoal yeast extract agar, BCYE for short, in the presence of iron and cysteine, which are added to aid in its growth. Now let's test your memory, or ATP loyalty. Do you remember what other bacteria need the same agar to be cultured? We said it in our Brucella video. The answer is Brucella, Francisella, and Pasteurella. We supplement this agar with antibiotics and silver stain. The antibiotics prevent other organisms from growing, and silver stain helps visualize Legionella. If an immediate diagnosis is required and there is no time for culturing, then a urine antigen test can be done for rapid diagnosis. Also, hyponatremia can be a helpful clue in patients with suspected Legionella infection. Before we get to its clinical importance, it's time for our surprise quiz to see if you are concentrating or not. What do we add to the BCYE to culture Legionella? Answer is iron and cysteine. Right, now moving on. Legionella can cause lobar as well as interstitial, also known as atypical pneumonia. In addition to that, it can cause two types of diseases. The first one is called Legionnaires' disease. In this disease, patient will present to you with mild symptoms and the pneumonia can progress to a more severe stage if not appropriately managed. So, how can we differentiate this from other types of atypical pneumonia? Well, fear not. Legionella patients present with three unique features. They will present with high fever, they will also have GI symptoms like watery diarrhea, nausea and vomiting, and abdominal pain, and thirdly, they can have CNS symptoms. These patients may have hyponatremia, which can also lead to confusion. Also, remember that Legionella patients will show patchy infiltrate with consolidation of one lobe on X-ray, although this is not always the case. The second disease Legionella patients can have is called Pontiac fever. This is a mild form of Legionella infection. It's a type of flu-like illness which is self-limiting, and patients will present with fever, malaise, fatigue, chills, and headache. These patients, however, do not develop pneumonia, and thus, chest radiographs are usually normal. Now, in regards to its transmission, it causes infection due to inhalation of aerosolized bacteria. However, it's not considered an airborne pathogen. Classically, you will see cases of Legionella at hotels caused by contaminated water aerosols, including air conditioning. It can also cause nosocomial pneumonia in nursing homes. It's worth mentioning that Legionella cannot spread from person to another. Now for the treatment, both fluoroquinolones and macrolides can be used for the treatment of Legionella pneumophila, so things like ciprofloxacin and erythromycin. As for Legionella prevention, currently we don't have a vaccine for it. However, we can still reduce its transmission by ensuring that water systems in buildings are well maintained. This includes hot tubs, water tanks and heaters, plumbing systems, and fountains. Alright, to summarize. Legionella is a facultative intracellular rod, which can also be considered a weak gram-negative organism. Since it doesn't gram stain well, we can use silver stain instead to identify it. It can be cultured on BCYE agar. It causes Legionnaires' disease and Pontiac fever, and for the treatment, we either use a macrolide or a fluoroquinolone. And that's it for Legionella. We hope you found it helpful. Don't forget to like, share, and subscribe to receive our latest explanations. And as always, thanks for watching.